Our episode starts out with a woman running for her life while a man slowly stalks her. She ends up trapped at a gate. Her demeanor then changes, and she turns to face the guy. As the guy struggles to open a box, he walks backward and falls. The last thing you hear is him scream as she slowly walks toward him with an evil smirk. Back at the police station, Steve tells his dad about the victim they found and that the guy was drained of blood, which stumps them. At the hospital, Jack is getting prepared to be honored as one of LA's most eligible bachelors. Once at the party, Jack is approached by the editor of the magazine putting on the contest, Mariah Thomas. Thomas tells Jack he is personally responsible for selecting the finalists. She takes him to the back and then introduces to the room the bachelors, though clearly giving Jack the eyes. At the end of the night, Jack is dancing with Mariah, but right before it gets too hot, another of the bachelors steps in, resulting in Jack leaving. Mariah takes him to her room, and the last you hear is him screaming. The next day, Steve and his dad again are at the police station discussing the newest victim, all drained of blood. Meanwhile, Jack is getting mocked for being involved in the eligible bachelor contest. Back in the hospital, Mark and Amanda are examining the body, and Mark makes notes of marks on the throat that the coroner didn't mention, and that blunt force trauma on that part of the body may have been used to cover it up. Back at the mansion, the head of the magazine, Ivan Bach, and one of the bachelors who plays for a football team he owns gets into an argument, which the others have to break up. The detectives then interview him about the latest victim who was last seen at the mansion. Bach states that the guy left early, but Jack denies that, stating that he was the last to leave, and that when he left, the guy was dancing with Mariah. When the detectives ask to talk to Mariah, they're told she is resting, and she'd get in touch with them when she wakens. Bach tells them to get a warrant if they want to look around, but when Steve then goes to interrogate the room, Bach changes his mind and lets them in. They end up going to a storage room in the basement and find a coffin. Just before Mark can open it, Bach fake falls and asks them to walk him out. Mark, back in his office, tells Amanda that the house has no mirrors. She walks out, then comes right back in once she realizes that Mark must believe the murders are the work of a vampire. That night, Mariah in a stunning black gown comes down the steps and meets with Steve. When asked about what happened to the last victim, Mariah truthfully states that her and the last victim danced, then she had a midnight snack and he left and wasn't talkative when he was leaving, i.e. she fed on him, then dumped the body. Mariah then goes to dance with Jack, but Mark steps in. Mark interrogates Mariah, letting her know his belief that the killer thinks they are a vampire and that he wants to help them, which she seems to take offense to. Another of the bachelors then steps in, and as she dances with them, she gives Mark a stare. The next day, that bachelor who was Bach's star football player is found dead the same way as the others, and once again is placed with Mariah. They also identify the original guy as a professor of paranormal studies who showed up when she did, and that they can't find any background on Mariah. Mark and Steve head back to the mansion to interrogate Bach on where Mariah came from. Steve then tells him about the newest murder and asks him to come down to the coroner's office to identify the body. Mark stays behind, using the excuse that he is just going to wait for a car, and when they leave, he heads back to the storage room. This time, the coffin that was there is gone. He heads back to the house and finds the coffin in a large bedroom. He goes to open it and is surprised to find it empty. Back at the hospital, Jack is in a great mood. He tells Mark and Amanda that he has a date with Mariah. Mark tries to tell Jack that Mariah is not right in the head and is the main suspect in the murders. When Mark explains the vampire theory, Jack laughs it off and goes off anyway. Mark tries to get Jack's supervisor to make him work that day to save him, which he eventually agrees to do. Mark then goes to what he thinks is Jack to apologize about him having to work another shift, just to find out that Jack's wish was someone else and left for the day with Mariah anyway. Steve arrives at the mansion first to bring Bach back to the station for questioning, as he is now Steve's prime suspect, Steve not knowing about Mark and Amanda's vampire theory or Mariah. Bach, on the way out, asks Mariah to take care of the mess in the kitchen, which we find out he means Jack. Jack comes out with some wine and starts asking Mariah about the others, but she instead wants to dance. After more double entendres where he thinks she's talking about sex, but she's actually talking about feeding on him, she sends him upstairs to her room. She then lights some candles, but before she can head upstairs, is interrupted by Mark, who storms in looking for Jack. Mariah then admits to all the murders and says she did it in exchange for a new passport, as her last one expired in 1938. She then tells him that she sleeps in a bed and the coffin is only used for traveling, followed by lifting him up and throwing him across the room, saying that the myth about vampires as true is their strong. Mariah then floats across the room and psychoanalyzes Mark, telling him that maybe vampires aren't real and he's just hallucinating. Jack then comes downstairs to ask what's going on, and when Mark tells him to run, she flings Mark across the room again. She then taunts Mark before Jack hits her in the back with some type of stick, which just angers Mariah. She breaks the stick in two and flings Jack across the room. She then decides to start with dessert and begins flying toward Jack, but is met with a wooden stick through the heart just as she lands. Before she dies, she once again confesses to the murders and doing it at Bach's request. Back in Mark's office, they discuss the case against Bach. Someone delivers the box that the first victim had with the news that they reconstructed what the contents was. Mark opens it just to find a wooden stake. Steve thinks it's a joke, but Mark and Jack know it's very real. This wasn't much of a vampire episode as there was no on-screen vampirism and no fangs at any point, but the casting was at least on point. Mariah Thomas was played by actress Julie Carmen. If you want to see Julie truly playing a vampire role, you'll have to look no further than in the 1988 film Fright Night 2. In it, she plays Regine Dandridge, the seductive sister to the main vampire of the original 1985 film, seeking revenge against those who destroyed him.
You mind if I smoke?
Oh, no, not at all. Please do.
Got it, thanks. I'd kill for a cup of coffee.
Instant? Be all right? Drink a lot of this during finals, you know? Gotta stay up all night.
You remind me of someone.
Is that Charlie Cassidy?
No, that's my cousin. This guy had a mouth like yours, good lips. And he knew how to use them. Do you know how to use your lips, Charlie?
Thanks for watching. If you like this content, please leave a like and subscribe and hit the bell icon to know every time I update. If you want to help my channel grow, please check out my Patreon where you can get access to content early as well as see the content that can't be uploaded here on YouTube. Link will be in the description. Until next time.